Melbourne, Australia, as Naomi Osaka strode through the Champions Walk leading to the court for the Australian Open final, headphones on her ears, racket bag strapped to her back, she reached out her left hand to tap a panel marked with her name and the year of her previous title there. "Not a big deal," she explained. "Just a bit of superstition." Less than 10 minutes later, she began the match against Jennifer Brady. And less than 1.5 hours later, Osaka won the last point, because that's what she does when the stakes are the greatest on her sport's biggest stages. Osaka improved to 4-0 in Grand Slam finals by grabbing 6 consecutive games to pull away in what initially was a tight contest, beating Brady 6-4, 6-3 at Melbourne Park on Saturday. "You don't go into a final wanting to be the runner-up. For me, I feel like every opportunity that I play a slam is an opportunity to win a slam," said 23-year-old Osaka, who will move up to No. 2 in the WTA rankings. "So I think maybe I put that pressure on myself too much, but honestly, it's working out in my favor right now." With serves that reached 122 miles per hour and produced 6 aces, and returns that helped create 6 breaks, Osaka became the first woman to win her first 4 major finals since Monica Seles did it 30 years ago. That is part of Osaka's 12-0 record in quarterfinals, semi-finals and finals at the majors. "She plays so aggressive that she puts so much pressure on you to perform well," said Brady, a 25-year-old from Pennsylvania who played college tennis at UCLA and was participating in a slam final for the first time. "And that's something that not every tennis player has that ability to do." Osaka, the 2020 AP Female Athlete of the Year, is also on a 21-match winning streak that dates to last season and includes her championship at last year's US Open. She also won the US Open in 2018 and the Australian Open in 2019. "What I have learned on and off the court is it's okay to not be sure about yourself. For me, I feel like I've always forced myself to, like, be strong, or whatever. I think if you're not feeling okay, it's okay to not feel okay," Osaka said. "But you have to sort of go within yourself and figure things out in a way." Osaka was born in Japan to a Japanese mother and a Haitian father, and she and her family moved to the United States when she was 3. She has been a vocal advocate for Black victims of racism and police violence, saying at one tournament last year that she would refuse to play a match to spotlight the issue. "She's such an inspiration to us all, and what she's doing for the game is amazing in getting the sport out there," said Brady, who was seated 22nd. "I hope young girls at home are watching and inspired by what she's doing." Brady had to go through a hard quarantine for 15 days when she arrived in Australia in January because someone on her flight tested positive for COVID-19 when they arrived.